This is Adam Gorney, the National Recruiting Director at Rivals, here with National Recruiting Analyst Adam Friedman. And today we are talking about two defensive ends that we're trying to make the case for as the top weak side defensive end in the 2023 class. Really not a bad decision here, either way you go about it. Matayo Uiagalelei, who is a phenomenal player at Bellflower, California, St. John Bosco, and Keon Keeley, who is committed to Notre Dame and got an Ohio State offer in recent days. So that will be also something to watch. Adam, I'm going to take Matayo in this one, but you start with Keon. Make your case and tell me why you're wrong.
Well, easy East Coast, West Coast for you to pick there. I'm a big Keon Keeley fan, though. One of these new age kind of edge hybrid players, defensive end, outside linebacker, has a great motor. He can fly all over the field. I think he's further from his ceiling than Matayo is, which is actually a good thing when it comes to the rankings, because I think he's got a lot more room to fill out. I think he's got a lot more potential that we're going to see him at the next level really fill out and be able to take on those big blockers that he's going to see at Notre Dame if he does end up there, maybe at Ohio State, some of those big Big Ten tackles. He got a Georgia offer fairly recently also, so maybe he ends up in the SEC. Either way, this guy's a big-time pass rushing threat. You know, as we saw Matayo. You've seen Matayo so many times. I saw him this past camp season out at the LA Rivals camp, and you know, he's such a phenomenal athlete. He can do so many different things that, you know, I'm not quite sure he's as dynamic though as a pass rusher. I'm excited to see what they turn into though before they get to the college level.
Yeah, you can't go wrong with Keon Keeley. He is long, athletic, rangy. He tracks people down, all the things that you like about an edge rusher, but rarely do you get guys that look like Matayo. I mean, he's 6'4". He's about 260 pounds, maybe 250, 260 in that range when he's playing. And that's kind of the strange part here. We still have him at weak side defensive end, and that we talked about that, but he is really just so great off the edge, so fast and athletic at that size that you really just don't see guys like that. I mean, he plays tight end on offense. He can kind of stretch the field, go across the middle. That really makes him special there. He's definitely a defensive guy long-term, though. And, you know, during his junior season, he was playing some of the best offensive tackles in Southern California, a very tough schedule. And he was just completely dominating the competition. You know, he could power you. He could finesse you to the outside. He can go inside. He cleans up. You know, there are times when Mateo's on the field and he's kind of walking around and it doesn't look like he's breaking a sweat. And then, you know, you look at the stats after the game and he has 10 tackles and 4 sacks and you're like, wow, it's just an amazing, amazing production from him all year on both sides of the football. So in terms of Keeley's recruitment, committed to Notre Dame, I think he told me that, you know, he's still sticking with Notre Dame. We'll see what that coaching situation looks like. He's going to have a lot of options. So is Matayo. I think USC is going to be very, very involved here with Lincoln Riley, Ohio State, Georgia, some other schools. So it will be interesting to see how it plays out. Neither are 5 stars yet, but both have that 5-star potential. So as we kind of draw this class out and get to about 30, around 35 stars, both will be in contention. But for today, that is Adam Friedman and Adam Gorney for Rivals.com.